criminal. The Italian Vaccine Research and Advocacy Organization Corbelva recently released new data regarding the use of aborted fetal cells in vaccines. The research reports the results produced from the MRC5 cell line analysis, particularly the one contained in GlaxoSmithKline's measles, mumps, rubella, and chickenpox vaccine. The Corbelva team summarized their findings as follows. 1. The fetal cell line was found to belong to a male fetus. 2. The cell line presents itself in such a way that it is likely to be very old, thus consistent with the declared line of the 1960s. 3. The fetal DNA represented in this vaccine is a complete individual genome, that is, the genomic DNA of all the chromosomes of an individual is present in the vaccine. 4. The human genomic DNA contained in this vaccine is clearly, undoubtedly abnormal, presenting important inconsistencies with the typical human genome, that is, with that of a healthy individual. 5. 560 genes known to be associated with forms of cancer were tested and all underwent major modifications. 6. There are variations whose consequences are not even known, not yet appearing in the literature, but which still affect genes involved in the induction of human cancer. 7. What is also clearly abnormal is the genome excess showing changes in the number of copies and structural variants. The DNA contained in these vaccines are potentially tumorigenic. Corvelva notes that according to the guidelines, the presence of fetal DNA from cell lines MRC5 and WI38 as diploids does not provide for upper limits. There is no limit to the amount they can find inside a vaccine. As a consequence, this vaccine should be considered defective and potentially dangerous to human health, in particular to the pediatric population, which is much more vulnerable to genetic and autoimmune damage. Human children, in other words, are being injected with the genetically modified DNA of another aborted human child in order to cause cancer on a nationwide scale, all to benefit the bottom line of the pharmaceutical industry that pushes total censorship about any criticism of vaccines or vaccine ingredients. So to reiterate, if your baby is a girl and receives this complete male human genome, the consequences may not only be cancer, but gender identity disorder and gender confusion. Same goes for the female aborted fetal cell, WI38. Given to a male baby may cause gender identity issues as well, insertional mutagenesis and autoimmunity-induced diseases caused by human fetal and retroviral residual toxins in vaccines means fetal DNA incorporates into the child's DNA causing mutations. With the passing of California's SB 276 and SB 714, which was signed into law, Robert Kennedy Jr. gave this response. It's a sad day for our country, and I have to ask a question. I'd like to ask these legislators who voted for this god-awful bill. If we can give government and big industries the right to inject untested medical products that are zero liability into our children, where does the power of government end? This is criminal. He also told the people, don't despair. Children's Health Defense has a plan. We have a strategy, and we are going to sue them. Every time there is a loss, we get stronger. We are going to win.